we perform Shakespeare plays. Hello everybody and welcome to our play. We apologize that you had to sit on rotting wood, but fifth graders worked really hard to make the seating area for all of us to sit on and enjoy plays. The reason why we perform Shakespeare plays is because its writings are timeless and full of meaning. And children can learn so much from studying the work of this famous author while understanding the history behind his writing. Throughout the year, we have learned about different types of writing and different elements of stories. And during our time doing these plays, we have learned to be more expressive with our characters and have fun taking our roles and putting our own spin on them.
Macbeth is a play about a brave Scottish general named Macbeth. Where he receives a prophecy from three witches that one day he will become king of Scotland. He then, consumed by his ambition, he kills the king and takes the Scottish throne for himself. He is then racked with guilt by his actions. Now enjoy the play.
Scotland is threatened by an army from Norway, supported by Scottish traitors. Strange things begin to happen. As Duncan, King of Scotland, prepares to honor his general, Macbeth, for his bravery in battle, three witches also plan to greet Macbeth with an eerie prophecy.
When shall we three meet again in thunder, lightning, or in rain?
When the hurly-burly's done, when the battle's lost and won.
That will be ere the set of sun.
Upon the heath.
There to meet with Macbeth.
Fair is foul and foul is fair. Hover through the fog and fill the air.
Meanwhile, in the king's camp near the battlefield, news of Macbeth's bravery and skills arrive yet again.
What bloody man is that?
A sergeant who fought for my freedom, father. Hail, Ranger, and tell the king of your news.
Christ Macbeth to standing fortune has slain the traitor, MacDonald's by Sharing with Norway. But then the Norwegian lord began a precious task.
When Macbeth and Banquo is made,
no, they redoubled their strokes on the foe.
God save the king! Norway and the treacherous Thane of Cawdor are beaten. Macbeth falls to us.
We will grant Macbeth the Thane of Cawdor's title as a reward for his bravery. But Cawdor hath lost, Macbeth hath won.
While riding home from their victory in battle, Macbeth and his friend Banquo met the three witches standing on the heath.
A drum, a drum, Macbeth don't come.
So foul and fair a day I have not seen. What are these so wretched and so wild in their attic? Are they witches? Speak if you can. What are you?
All hail Macbeth, Thane of Flamis.
All hail Macbeth, Thane of Calm.
All hail Macbeth, thou shalt be king hereafter.
But sir, why do you start and seem to fear things? What do you sound so fair? What of me would you speak then to me?
Hail!
Lesser than Macbeth.
Not so happy yet, Richard.
All hail Banquo, the father of kings.
Stay, tell me more. What do you mean? I don't even belong this, but another man is Thane of Calidore. Say from whence you owe the strange intelligence. Speak, I charge you.
Suddenly, the witches vanish.
Where'd they go?
They vanished
into the air, melted as breath into the wind. No children shall be king.
You shall be king!
And Thane of Cawdor too, went it not so.
Into this unusual scene were Ross and Angus with a message from King Duncan.
Hail, Macbeth! The king hath happily received news of thy success.
They are sent here to give me thanks from our royal master.
And call thee Thane of Cawdor.
What did the witches speak truth? Thanks for your pains. Two truths are told, and happy prologues to swelling act. The witches' words could not be ill, could not be good. If chances will have me king, my chances may crown me.
Macbeth's amazement that what the witches had said had come true made him begin to think about becoming king. He told his wife about it in a letter.
The witches said, "Hail, thou shalt be king hereafter. This I thought good to deliver me. My dearest part of goodness, lay it to thy heart. Flame as thou art become, so the three witches promise this to you, then my husband, you'll become king too. I have the right."
Lady Macbeth thought some more about her plan and attend to enter with interesting news.
center for this terrible feat. A false face was high, but the false heart doth know.
Late that night, as Macbeth headed to Duncan's room, he met Banquo and his son Fleece.
Who's the night for?
The moon is down.
Who's there?
A friend.
As well, I dreamed last night of three witches. Weren't they said to you has some truth?
I think not of them. You and your son should now go to bed. Good repose, the wise.
Thanks so much to you.
Sleep well.
As Banquo and Fleece left, Macbeth had a vision of the knife in the air before him.
Is this a dagger I see before me? The handle towards my hand. Come, let me clutch thee. I have thee not, and I see thee still. Fatal vision, dagger of the mind. I go now. It is done.
Waiting for Macbeth to return, Lady Macbeth and Banquo heard an owl scream and crickets cry. Suddenly, Macbeth returns.
Who's there, my husband?
I have done the deed, but Macbeth, I heard a voice cry, sleep no more. Macbeth does murder sleep. Macbeth shall sleep no more. Look at my hands. They are bloody!
Wash this filthy with this blood from your hands, but why'd you bring these daggers from the place? Go back and smear back in sleeping guards with blood.
I'll go no more. I'm afraid to think what I have done. Look on it again. I dare not.
Give me the daggers. I'll do it.
Why you do it? Whence is that knocking? How is it with me when every noise appalls me?
As Lady Macbeth returned, Macbeth stared at the blood on her hands.
My hands are bloody now too, but I'm not a coward. A little water clears off the steam. I hear knocking. Hark! More knocking. Get on your nightgown and greet whoever has come to our gate.
As Macbeth and his wife changed, a porter opened the front gate and met Macduff and Lennox, two of King Duncan's men. They are greeted by Macbeth.
Good morrow, both. Is the king stirring?
Not yet. I'll make it so bold to wake him.
Ah! Oh, her! Her!
What's the matter?
The king is murdered! Murder and treason! Banquo, Malcolm, Donalbin! Awake, up and see! Ring the bell!
As Macbeth and Lennox ran to see the king, Lady Macbeth and Banquo entered shaken.
What's this business?
Oh, Banquo, our royal master's murdered!
Oh, at last! What in our house?
Too cruel, Inigo.
Into this horrifying scene ran the king's son, Malcolm, and Donovan.
What's going on? What's happening?
Your royal father's murdered!
But who did this?
His guards, their hands and faces were baked in blood, so were their daggers.
In a rush, Macbeth and Lennox returned.
Repent me of my fury, but I did kill them!
Help me, heads, help!
Pretending to faint, Lady Macbeth drew attention away from her husband for the moment.
Look to the lady and let us meet in question this bloody piece of wood.
Dear King Duncan's son fled Macbeth's castle, and this made some suspicious that they had committed the murder. But Banquo, who knew of the three witches' prophecy, suspected that Macbeth was guilty, especially when Macbeth was soon crowned king by his Scottish lord. Recognizing his friend's suspicions, Macbeth hired two murderers to kill his friend Banquo.
Both of you know Banquo, your enemy.
Yes, my lord.
So he is mine, then. I need your help.
We shall, my lord, perform what you command us.
In the struggle with the murderers, Banquo was killed, but his son Fleece escaped. Rather than make him feel this news from the murderers and the murder of King Duncan, Macbeth feel nervous, and he started to sleep. At a dinner later that day, he saw the ghost of Banquo sitting at a table in his sleep. No one else could see the ghost. Lady Macbeth had to hurry Macbeth from the room.
Welcome, your majesty.
May it please your highness to sit, sir?
Where? The table's full.
Here is a place to serve, sir.
Who is this? Where did you have done this?
What, my good lord?
Thou cannot say I did it! Never shake thy blue locks at me!
Gentlemen, rise, his highness not well.
Why do you make such faces? You look without this tool.
Abort, I grit my sight. Thy blood is cold and sorrowful shadow.
You have displaced me. You have displaced the mirth. Come with me, my lord. A kind good night to all.
Good night, and better health attend his head.
to me.
The apparition rose slowly from the cauldron and answered Macbeth's question.
Macbeth shall never vanquish me until Burnham went to High Dennis and Hale shall come against him.
That will never be.
Meanwhile, back at her castle, Lady Macbeth began to feel very guilty for having her king and Banquo killed. She also began to feel very nervous that the Scottish lords were arming against her husband. She began wiping her hands again and again, imagining she had blood on her hands.
Yeah, here's a spot. Out for spot. Out, I say. Here's the smell of blood show. Oh, I cannot wash it away. What's done cannot be undone.
When Macbeth returned, he saw the Scottish lords' army massing against him. However, just before the battle, attendants told Macbeth that his wife was dead and some other troubling news.
Ah! Wherefore was that cry?
The queen, my lord, is dead!
Oh, out, brief candle, life's but a walking shadow. A broad prayer and stress and frets this hour upon the stage, then is heard no more. The tale told me an idiot, for sound and fury signifying nothing.
I should report what else I saw, as I did stand upon it. I thought the wood began to move!
Liar! Arm, arm, and out! Ring the alarm bell! Blow, wind! Come, wreck!
Soon Macbeth saw what the attendant had said was true. The opposing army had cut the branches from Burnham Wood and carried the branches before them to hide their numbers. On the battlefield, Macbeth met an army that included Malcolm, dead King Duncan's son, Macduff, and other Scottish lords. They wanted revenge for things that Macbeth had done. On the battlefield, Macbeth met Macduff, and they had a terrible sword fight.
Yield, thief coward! I will not yield! Ah!